are here at the Presidential Election Petition Tribunal, where the five-man panel is about to adopt the final arguments of all the parties involved. Atiku Abubakar of the PDP is challenging the outcome of the February 23 presidential elections. And of course, he did deliver a 43-pager of his final argument just on 14th of August. Of course, Buhari's team, APC team, INEC team have also submitted theirs, and the panel today is about to adopt all these arguments. To talk more about this and a whole lot of other issues involved, I am standing with Tunde Oyeshino. He is, as a matter of fact, the head of the judiciary correspondence here in Abuja, and he is a lawyer. Thanks for talking to Roots TV Nigeria.
Thank you very much.
So what are your thoughts? Let's start with Atiku Abubakar's final argument. He made a lot of allegations, and he has brought his argument. What do you think about his argument?
Well, the crux of Atiku's argument, after calling about 62 witnesses in his final written address, is telling the tribunal that with the evidence of the 62 witnesses he had called, he had been able to establish three facts. The first fact was that INEC transmitted result electronically from what part of his witnesses said during their testimony. And secondly was that the President Muhammadu Buhari did not submit any academic qualification, any certificate with the form he submitted to INEC. And the third issue he raised in his final written address was that he was telling the tribunal that he had been able to prove that some results was doctored to favor President Muhammadu Buhari. Those are the three grounds in which Atiku premised his final written address. And for the camp of the President Muhammadu Buhari, the APC and INEC, they were saying that the petitioners have not been able to prove evidentially their case at the tribunal. On the ground of the electronic server, they didn't call much witnesses, and they were saying in their final written address that it was submitted during evidence that the chairman of INEC in one of the press conference stated that they would not be able to use server because of the way it is at the moment. They were hanging on that, and they were also saying that in the first place, the tribunal should not even hear the petition of Atiku Abubakar. Why? Because he's not a Nigerian. They are claiming he's a Cameroonian. So in the first place, he's not even qualified to contest, let alone bringing a petition to the court. And they were also insisting that President Muhammadu Buhari is academically qualified contest. So in all, they were urging the tribunal to dismiss the petition of Atiku Abubakar and PDP in its entirety for lack of evidential proof.
At the moment, we know that the Supreme Court has actually dismissed Atiku's application to issue them access into the server, upholding what the tribunal had ruled some time ago. How do you see that playing out here? Do you think, because this was majorly one of the basis for which Atiku Abubakar is challenging this elections. With that happening at the Supreme Court, how do you see it playing out here?
Well, if you listen to what the counsel to Atiku Abubakar at the Supreme Court yesterday said, Eita Ojagire, senior advocate of Nigeria, he said they had envisaged such type of judgment, and because of that they have tied their hand while they were presenting their petition at the tribunal. So I want to believe they have taken into consideration that the Supreme Court might dismiss that application when they get there, and I want to believe at the tribunal here they might have tied all hands to make sure that they present their case beyond reasonable doubt. And I even think beyond the server issue, the issue of academic qualification has much more weight.
As a matter of fact, I was even about to come to that. Even though the President Buhari and INEC, especially INEC, is saying that look, this was a pre-election issue. As a matter of fact, if you felt that he did not submit academic qualifications, you should have brought that matter up before the elections. However, even their own, even President Buhari's own witnesses somehow did counter each other when it came to his qualifications, his WAEC result, his Cambridge result, that has even led to some people petitioning Cambridge and the UK police to indict Abba Kyari on this matter. So how do you think, you said it's weighty, in this situation, how do you think it can play out to the favor of the Atiku camp?
Well, everything will be passed to the timetable of the five-man panel. We can't preempt them. The matter is before them.
Do you think it's weighty enough to make any sort of impact?
Well, personally, to me, from my own thinking and by my own thinking, I think the issue of qualification is a bit more weighty, because something cannot be built on nothing. If you don't have the qualification to contest in the first place, even after you might have contested, it still amounts to nullity. Mm-hmm.
Now let's also talk about the fact that billions of naira was, you know, alloted, budgeted for this said server, which is said to not exist at this moment. First of all, do you think that will play out in the decision to be made? Secondly, even after the tribunal, do you see a possibility where some petitioners could take INEC to court to say, explain to us what happened to all of this money if you say a server did not exist?
Now, there are two things involved here. One, non-usage of server, and the allocation of billions of naira for the server. Now, the issue of the server is not contained in the Electoral Act. So even if it is used, as far as the Electoral Act do not recognize it, the law is not all about emotion. It's not all about what should be. It's about what the law is saying. So that is on one leg. The other leg is some other people may come up after this tribunal, of course, which I believe the issue of server might not in any way affect the judgment of the tribunal. It might not even work in the favor of the petitioner. But the other leg is that some people may come after this tribunal to take INEC to court, that despite the fact that the huge amount that is committed to that server, it's not being used. That's another leg on its own.
Interesting. And we are still here to watch and see what goes on. Well, this is basically an oral aspect of this. The big deal will happen when the judgment will be passed.